first instructor used to say, the best part of flying is landing in one piece. Today, you're in charge of bringing us in for a safe landing. And I've already set us up in landing configuration at 65 knots with 10 degrees of flaps and idle power. Keep your aim point on the runway threshold. When you're 10 feet above the runway, it's time to flare. Reduce throttle to idle. Now focus on the end of the runway and pull back slightly on the yoke to aim the nose just above it. Nice. Now apply the brakes to slow us down and bring the plane to a stop. You did well, but you can do better. Keep in mind that approaching the runway at the right speed is key to a good landing. First instructor used to say, the best part of flying is landing in one piece. Today, you're in charge of bringing us in for a safe landing. And I've already set us up in landing configuration at 65 knots with 10 degrees of flaps and idle power. Keep your aim point on the runway threshold. When you're 10 feet above the runway, it's time to flare. throttle to idle. Now focus on the end of the runway and pull back slightly on the yoke to aim the nose just above it. Nice. Now apply the brakes to slow us down and bring the plane to a stop. You did well, but you can do better. Keep in mind that approaching the runway at the right speed is key to a good landing. My first instructor used to say, the best part of flying is landing in one piece. Today, you're in charge of bringing us in for a safe landing. And I've already set us up in landing configuration, at 65 knots with 10 degrees of flaps and idle power. Keep your aim point on the runway threshold. When you're 10 feet above the runway, it's time to flare. Reduce throttle to idle. Now focus on the end of the runway and pull back slightly on the yoke to aim the nose just above it. Nice. Now apply the brakes to slow us down and bring the plane to a stop. You did well, but you can do better. Keep in mind that approaching the runway at the right speed is